Well, the bill also does not extend unemployment benefits that will affect about 1.3 million Americans beginning 3 days after Christmas. 11 News reporter Joshua Davidsburg joins us now with that part of the story. Josh.
Donna, I talked to the Department of Labor Licensing and Regulation earlier this evening, and they said that 25,000 Marylanders will be affected.
It's graduation day for the Accelerating Connections to Employment class in Anne Arundel County.
I think we can get out there and compete with everyone else that's looking for a job, and I actually think we have an advantage.
They have equipped me so that I can go out there and should be able to be successful.
These 9 students have spent the past 11 weeks learning job skills to score an IT job, and for about 30% of them, that means getting off unemployment. Graduate Tracy Anderson has already run out of unemployment.
It's going to be tough without unemployment. It takes money to get out there and go on interviews. You still have to provide for your family. You still have to pay mortgages.
Come December 28th, 25,000 Marylanders and 1.3 million people nationwide will join Anderson and lose their long-term unemployment benefits. It wasn't in the budget the Senate passed today.
Some of the Republicans are still willing to consider putting it back in, especially in the Senate. But they argue that they're going to have to find a funding source.
Matthew Crenson is a professor emeritus and political science expert from Johns Hopkins. He said long-term unemployment insurance was dropped as a compromise.
This is, you know, may well have kept us from another government shutdown, from more time-consuming acrimony between Democrats and Republicans. I think both parties were ready to try to demonstrate that they could actually govern.
But while unemployment is up for debate, for these students, they're focused on the opposite, graduating from the program and finding their next job.
Even though the budget has passed, Congress can still reinstate emergency unemployment benefits. It just has to be under new legislation. In the studio, Josh Davidsburg, WBAL-TV 11 News.